Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Dr. R.P. Rao's Academy. Myself Dr. Raja Prakash Rao. In this session, I will discuss about classification of elements. Let's start now. Classification of network elements. Classification of network elements. First one is active and passive elements. Active and passive elements. And the second one is linear and non-linear elements. And linear and non-linear. Linear and non-linear elements. And third one is bilateral and unilateral elements. Bilateral and unilateral elements. We will say about all these three things now. Let us start with the first one, active and passive elements. First one, active and passive elements. Active and passive elements. Let us say about active elements now. Active elements. Active elements are those which delivers power to the other elements in the circuit. Active elements. These are elements. The active elements are those elements. Active elements are those elements. Those elements which deliver power to other elements in the circuit. Example, voltage source and current source. Let us see the characteristic curve of these active elements. Let us consider an active element, that is voltage source, with internal resistance R, and I is the current, and V is the voltage source. Simply by applying Ohm's law, I is equal to 1 by R into V. V is equal to IR. V by I is equal to R is Ohm's law. But I have written like this, I is equal to 1 by R into V. It is like Y is equal to Mx. Let us draw the V characteristics of this element now. VI characteristics. Let us suppose V is representing X axis, I is representing Y axis. Then Y is equal to Mx space, it is nothing but the equation of line passing through the origin. This is the characteristic curve of this element, that is the active element. Y is equal to Mx. And in this case, the current will, the only the magnitude of the current is taken. If you, for positive and negative values of voltages, only the magnitude of the current is taken. If the voltage is increased, current will be positive, and voltage decreased, current will be negative or reduced. But here, in the case of active elements, we are considering only the magnitude of the current. So, even if you reverse the battery terminals, the current value will be same. Ammeter shows the same value. So, now if you reverse the battery terminals, the current will be flowing like this. In the circuit, it flows like this. From positive terminal to negative. Here it is positive, here it will be negative. Okay? But the current value is same, the magnitude is magnitude of the current. If you plot the characteristics, wave characteristics, the line will be like this. And will be like this. Okay, for active elements, the characteristics of the wave characteristics will be like this. Okay? That's all about the active elements. Now, let us see about the passive element. Now, passive elements will absorb the energy delivered by the active sources. Passive elements are those elements. Passive elements are those elements. Those elements which absorb the power delivered by the active elements. Example, resistors, inductors and capacitors. Let us see about the characteristic curve of this passive elements. That is the characteristics. For passive elements, the circuit will be like this. This is a passive element and I use the current to power the circuit, connect across battery D. By playing Ohm's law, the current will get I is equal to 1 by R into V. If you increase V, automatically current also increases. If you decrease the voltage, current also will be decreased. So if you plot the curve will be like this. So the characteristic curve or wave characteristics of the passive element will be like this. Will be like this. Vi. Okay, based on the characteristics curves, that is by simply seeing the characteristic curve, we can say whether the curve belongs to active element or passive element. Further, I will write a small note. If the ratio of I and V of any point of the characteristic curve, is negative, then that element is active element. Otherwise that is a passive element. So simply remember this point, that is the ratio of I and V of any point of the characteristic curve is negative. Any point if it is negative, then that element is active element. Otherwise, it is a passive element. Okay, now let us consider some characteristic curves and find out it belongs to which element, passive element or active element. First characteristic curve is like this. Passing through the origin, these are the wave characteristics of some element. We should find out whether, we should tell whether this is active or passive, just by simply seeing this characteristic curve. The second one is like this. VI characteristics. P axis plus I axis. The third one is like this. And the fourth one is like this. So find out, let's consider point in the third quadrant now. For this point, this is the value of I. I is negative and the V is also negative. So what is ratio of I and V? It's positive. Here, any point on this line, V is positive, I is positive. The first quadrant also is positive. So we can say that if any point is negative, we can directly say that the element corresponding to this characteristic curve is active element. Since it is positive, all the points are ratios, that is I by V ratio of any point on this curve is positive, we can say that it is passive element. So the first curve is passive, it is the characteristic curve of a passive element. And the second one, let's consider point in the second quadrant now. V is negative, I is positive. So I by V is negative. We need not consider any other point. Anyway, one of the points is ratio is negative, then we can directly say that the element is active element. So this is active. This characteristic curve is just one into is a characteristic curve of an active element. Now the third one, it is like in third and fourth quadrant. Third quadrant, consider a point. Corresponding this point is V, I is negative, and here it is also negative. So I by V is ratio is positive in this case. Here positive, negative. So it is negative. So it is an active element. So if any one point is active, negative is, then we can say that it is the characteristic curve of an active element. Now here is positive, negative. So it is slope is negative. So it is also an active element. So in these three active elements are there for passive elements. Then next we'll see about linear and non-linear elements. The second point, the classification of the two elements. The second one is linear and non-linear elements. Second one is linear and non-linear elements. Let us see about linear elements now. Linear elements are those elements which shows linear relationship between voltage and current. Just remember this. That means linearly, they should vary linearly. V is increased, I also should be increased. V is decreased, I also must be decreased. That is the linear relationship. So linear elements are those elements which show a linear relationship between voltage and current. If V increases, I also increase. If V decreases, I also decrease. So this is a characteristic curve of passive elements. So all the passive elements are linear elements. So example, all passive elements, that is R, L and C, passive elements are linear elements. Next we will see what is non-linear elements. Non-linear which do not show, which do not show a linear relationship between voltage and current. Okay. The examples can be now, which do not show means that those are nothing but the active elements only. So what are the active elements? Example, voltage source, and current source. So non-linear elements, example, active elements, then drop will be, that is the current curve will be like this. In the reverse case, can be downward also, it can be in the third and fourth quadrant also. So next, we will see about the third one, that is bilateral and unilateral. Unilateral elements Nonlinear elements are those elements which allows current in only one direction and it won't allow from the other direction. So unilateral elements are those elements, which allows current in one direction only, hence impedance offered, by this element, is different for the two currents. That is for this unilateral element.
That's all for today's session.